Yo, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. Hope you guys like the other videos if you guys watch them. But anyways, I wanted to lower my truck. I kind of started and I was like, why not make a video out of it? So I'm gonna make a video out of it. I already dropped the front end. As you can see, it is a lot lower than what it was, and I've also got a pretty amount good of camber now since I lowered it. I probably lowered at least like, I'd probably say like 2 more inches or so. It did look like the back, if you guys can see here. I kind of have it jacked off the grounder now, but as you can see, like that's what it used to look like. I mean, I had it jacked up so on the axle, so it pushed it up a little bit more, but it's probably like a little bit lower than that, like the tire. But then look at this, like, I can put my fist in the air, and it fits perfectly. Now if I put my fist over here, I still got a lot of room. So, I dropped the front end a lot, so, and all I did was, with the lowering kit, I don't know if you guys watched that video, I got a ground force lowering kit, it's a 2-4 drop. But all I did was took the torsion bar bolt and just took it all the way out. So now I don't even have a torsion bar bolt. I just have that.
I'm inside my trucks right here. This is what they are. I'll crawl underneath the truck to show you guys. I'll stop right here. Oh yeah, Ester T seats. If you guys did not see that video, make sure you guys go watch that video. Install some nice seats. Whew. All right, so if you can look right here. Right there, you can see where the bolt used to go into. I wish I could crawl under here, but I can't. But it's like, right there, that's where it used to go up into. I took it out, so I dropped it a pretty decent amount.
Hey guys.
So that's basically what I did to the front to make it so much lower. The rear, I only got like one option to really do as of right now. There is another notch up on the shackle that I'm going to be putting the leaf springs up into. I'll show you that real quick.
So right here you got the leaf spring shackle, like the leaf spring, and you got the shackle. So as you can see, there's a hole right there. So basically I'm just going to move this up that little bit. I mean, it's probably going to give me like a half inch to an inch lower. But
if anyone else has any other ideas on how to drop it more, I would like to know, because I want to be able to match the front to the back. But for now, let's just do that real quick and see how it looks and see how I like it. Another thing I will be doing in this video, hopefully, wrapping the roof. I will be wrapping the roof in black. It's like a gloss black. I don't know where the wrap is, but I will find it and show you guys later after we are done lowering the truck. Alright, so I got the leaf springs up in that top hole, so this is basically what it looks like. I mean, I'll just show you guys anyways. There she is. There's that one. And there's that one. I just realized now I should have taken measurements before I did this so I know how much lower I went, but idiot of me, I totally forgot to do that. So I'll put the wheels on and see what it looks like, how it is. Alright, so got the wheels back on. Final truth, if it actually loaded or not. If it is sitting how it is right now, I will be extremely happy, because I think this looks pretty dang good. I mean, I don't know, we'll see. I'll lower it down and final truth if it actually loaded or not. Whew, can't wait. Oh yeah, boys. Yeah, she's sitting a lot lower than what it was. I'm pretty stoked.
Sitting pretty dang good, if you ask me. I mean, that's, it's pretty good. See, my lighting is terrible.
I'll take some measurements and see how much off we are to the front, to the back, and we'll go from there, I guess.
Right, so the rear, we're about like, let's just say 6 inches. I mean, it's a little less than that. Let's just say 5.5, 6 inches. And then we'll go to the front. Front, we're at like, shit. Come on. We got like, maybe like 3.5, 4 inches. I mean, that's pretty decent. So, I mean, that's like 2 inches still higher in the back. I mean, I'm pretty happy with it. I would like to come down like at least like an inch more or so, but I would like it to be like completely level. I mean, I could level it if I put the torsion bolts back in. I lift it a little bit more, but I really like how the front end's sitting. Like, I don't know. I really like how it sits. It's like perfect. But the rear needs to come down more, I feel like. But I still feel like that's really good compared to what it used to be. Alright, so now we're going to put on the roof wrap. So, this is pretty much what it is. It's supposed to be semi-gloss, but it kind of looks gloss, but it's got all this dang wrinkles all the way down it, so hopefully we'll be able to heat that up and stretch it out and make it look nice, but yeah, it's going to be going up on top of there, and then I have plenty, so I'm going to make a nice big eyebrow for it, too. So. Alright, so we got the wrap here. We heated up a little bit. He's spraying the roof right now. We're ready to put it on, so here we are. So we got the wrap on the roof right now. We're smoothing it all out right now. It's looking pretty dang good. Got this clear wrap on it. So it's scratching it, but it'll come off. So it'll look like that instead of like all scratchy like that. Thanks to this guy right here, freaking master wrapper right here. Working on her. We got Connor out here putting in the work.
Aye, aye, Captain.
But yeah, it's going along slowly but surely.
Surely.
But yeah, I guess we'll pick up when we're getting a little bit closer.
That's nice. I love that. What happened when you crashed it? I said no one sold it.
Just got the hella stretch.
Alright, so we got the wrap all done and finished. It doesn't look the prettiest, but it's a home job. First time wrapping. It's alright. Next year, I might get it just professionally done, just so it looks a lot cleaner. I wanted to do an eyebrow. I didn't end up doing an eyebrow, but going into a Cars and Coffees tomorrow, so I kind of just threw the roof wrap on for now, but here she is. You can see. Looks pretty dang good. Here's the back. Looks pretty decent. Got the
Got the SRT flag all ready for tomorrow.
Hop on up in here. And here she is. It's alright. I mean, there's so few bubbles here and there, and the edges aren't like the best, but I mean, it is what it is. But yeah, I like how it looks. I
guess when it's nice out and light, daylight, probably tomorrow, the next day, I'll film what it looks like if it doesn't bubble up while we're at the car meet in the sun. So if it all works out and still looks good, I'll take videos and show you guys what it looks like in the sunlight. So yeah. All right, so it's daylight out. Show you guys the truck. Here it is.
I don't know. I think it looks so much better than what it did before. I like it black. I don't know if I'll put the eyebrow on. I don't think I'm gonna put the eyebrow on for the rest of the season just because it's starting to snow and it's just gonna get put away soon anyways. So the motor can get ripped out, but I think I might just have a tent and just come down a little bit longer. But other than that, sheesh. I think this thing looks amazing. I don't know what you guys think, but I think it looks a hell of a lot better. Come to the back. Sheesh. This will be another video right here, but anyways. Yeah, I think it looks so much better. Hell yeah.
I guess that's the end of the video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you guys want me to film any more videos of the truck before I put it away and start ripping it back apart again, comment down below. Let me know what you guys want to see, and I'll try and film it before the shitty weather comes or whatever. But, yep, I guess that's the end of the video. Hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you guys next time.